Okay, so this is a continuation of the last lecture. So very quickly to review, we were looking at this circuit, the simplest possible amplifier with a single transistor and a resistive load. And what we found was that the AC voltage gain of this circuit is minus GM RD, ignoring the RO of the MOSFET. And we found that for our numbers, that gain was coming out to be minus 4. And then we asked ourselves, well, how can we increase this gain by changing the circuit parameter values, and what is the maximum gain we can get from this circuit? So let us take it off from there. I hope you've had some time thinking about this and you have your own answers. Let me tell you my answers. So whenever we want to increase any quantity or change any quantity, the thing we do is we look at the equation for that quantity. So this equation is GMRD. So we say, well, if I want to increase the gain, I have to increase GM and or I have to increase RD. But it turns out, so let's say we increase RD. So how does increasing RD affect the drain current and the drain voltage? How does increasing GM affect the drain current and the drain voltage? How do we make sure that the transistor stays in saturation? How do we find the maximum limit? These become very quickly complex questions, or let me say they become complex as we push the limits. So for example, we can say, well, I can keep increasing RD in this equation as long as the transistor stays in saturation. So we had a value of 2 kilo ohms and we can increase it. In fact, let us look at the circuit. So if you recall, the current is 0.5 milliamps. And this is 2 kilo ohms and the gate voltage is 0.9. So the VD sat of this transistor is 0.5 volts. So as we increase RD, we can keep increasing it until the DC gate voltage, DC drain voltage reaches 0.5 volts. So what is the value for RD? So 0.5 means 2.5. So 5 kilo ohms, we can go to 5 kilo ohms. Right, at 0.5 kilo ohms, this voltage drop will be 2.5. So that is 2.5 times, so we'll get a gain of 10. But then we reach the limit, because if we increase RD any further, then the transistor goes into triode. So shall we conclude that the highest gain is minus 10? I mean, the magnitude is 10. Well, the next thing is, okay, what if I increase GM? But if I increase GM, then the drain current will change and the transistor will go out of triode. So these are not easy analyses. It turns out, fortunately, that there is a different way of writing this expression that gives us more insight and that gives us more direct information about increasing the gain. So let's look at it. So we write GM as, one of the ways of writing GM is 2ID over VGS minus VT. Alright, you should go back and look that this is correct. So GM is 2ID over VGS minus VT into RD. ID RD is the voltage drop across the drain resistance, and so that can be written as VDD minus VO, where VO is the DC drain voltage. This expression is much nicer to look at, to think about how to increase the gain of this circuit. So let's look at it. There are two variables here. VDD is of course given to us. One variable is VGS minus VT, the other is VO. Let us start with VO. So we say, well, to increase the gain because of this negative sign, we must make, to increase the magnitude of the gain, we must make VO small. And of course, we should also make VGS minus VT small. So let us start with VO. So how much can we reduce VO, the DC drain voltage? The lowest DC drain voltage is VGS minus VT, as we just saw, in fact. Therefore, we can go down to VGS minus VT for VO. So let us say we make the circuit, in fact, as we just did, we can, for example, make the RD larger, so that VO is equal to VGS minus VT. So let's substitute VO equal to VGS minus VT here in the expression. So we get VDD minus VGS minus VT, all that. So you get minus 2 Vt over Vgs minus Vt minus 1, that this is the Vgs minus Vt over Vgs minus Vt. Alright, so this gives us an expression for the gain where we have taken the extreme value of Vo. So as we so we can calculate, so this is 3 volts and with a VGS of 0.9, so 0.9 minus 0.4 is 0.5, so this is 6 minus 1, 5 and 10, which we got just a few minutes earlier. All right. Now, but there is an issue with this. The issue is that if we make VO equal to VGS minus VT, then when we apply an AC signal, for any AC signal applied, when the drain voltage goes below VO, the transistor will immediately go into triode because we've biased it at the edge of triode or edge of saturation. Therefore, this is really not, realistically speaking, this is a gain we can have, this is a useless gain, although the gain is there. At this, for these conditions, the transistor will be out of saturation for half of the sinusoidal cycle for any input voltage applied. So we say, well, what is the maximum gain I can get if I want a maximum voltage swing, which is the other extreme, right? At the this case is a minimum voltage swing. So if I want the maximum voltage swing, then I must place the DC drain voltage midway between VDD and VGS minus VT, because these are the extremes, as we had seen last time. These define the voltage swing, right? The maximum voltage and the minimum. So we place the DC drain voltage halfway, or the average of these two, which is this quantity, right? Then what is the gain we get? So we substitute this VO in this gain expression, and then we do all the calculations, and we get VDD by VGS minus VT minus 1 without the 2 outside. So let's compare. Here there is a 2, here there isn't a 2, all right? So this is the gain we can get, maximum gain we can get with respect to VO, all right? Now let us see what we can do with VGS minus VT. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a table of gain versus VGS minus VT. So we, of course, we want to make VGS minus VT smaller to make the gain larger. So we'll keep reducing VGS minus VT and calculate the gain from this expression with VDD equal to 3 volts. So VGS minus VT is 0.5, then this is 5, which we just saw actually indirectly. If we make this 0.1, then we'll get 29. 3 by 0.1 is 30 minus 1, 29. If we make it 10 millivolts, which is 0.01, then we'll get a gain of 299, right? 3 divided by 0.01 is 300, minus 1 is 299. If we make it, what is this? I'm sorry. This is not right. This is 10 microvolts. If we make it 10 microvolts, then what shall be the gain? I don't think it is 9. It must be 2 here, just by extension of these 2s. So, oh no, I'm sorry. 3 by 10 microvolts is how much? 330,000. 3 by 10 micro is 30,000, minus 1 is 29,999. All right, I may be missing a 0 or a, I don't know, this is 10 micro or 100 micro, you figure out, all right. The point is, this is of course startling, this is amazing. This equation and these numbers are telling us that I can get a gain of 30,000 from this simple circuit, all right? This is of course all an illusion. This is not true, and here are the two reasons why it is not true. First, it is not correct, because as VGS minus VT becomes small, the transistor is no longer in strong inversion, all right? and when it is not in strong inversion, the model we have used to derive this expression. So we assumed that the transistor was in saturation, strong inversion, to derive this expression. That expression itself becomes invalid when the VGS minus VT is so small. All right, so these numbers are incorrect because this equation is incorrect at such small VGS minus VT values. That is one. The other is a more practical consideration. This is more theoretical. Is that in any, whenever we fabricate an IC and we have a million or a billion MOSFETs, and they are fabricated, the fabrication process of course is the same for all these million MOSFETs on the chip, but the fabrication process has small variations from one region of the chip to another, even though the chip is small, so that the exact value of the threshold voltage of these million MOSFETs is not equal. There is a small variation in the threshold voltage value of the MOSFETs across any given chip. All right, that this is called process variation. There is also the other thing that happens is as we operate a MOSFET or as we operate a chip and currents are flowing all over the place, the chip heats up because of the dissipation of power. And as it heats up, the threshold voltage changes because the threshold voltage is a function of temperature. For both these reasons, the threshold voltage being variable and the necessity that we want to make sure that the transistor stays in strong inversion for it to be operating as a good amplifier, we have to make sure that as VT varies, that the VGS minus VT stays positive and a reasonably large number. Because if VT varies and VGS becomes less than VT, the transistor goes into sub-threshold and all our design equations and therefore the entire design will fail and therefore the circuit will not work as an amplifier. So as a rule of thumb, the industry tells, and the advice given by industry and based on all the experience of process variation is that we must keep VGS minus VT at least equal to 0.1 volt to ensure that with variations in VT, the variation in VGS minus VT is not a significant fraction. All right. So in fact, if you ask different industry engineers, they'll some will be conservative and they'll say, no, this should be 0.2. Some will say 0.15. In fact, 0.1 is pushing it, but because we are academicians and we are not going to actually fabricate these amplifiers we designed this semester, we'll keep this number as 0.1. But remember that if the process variation is large, this may have to become 0.15 or 0.2 volts also. All right, so what that means is that the smallest VGS minus VT, in fact, this is true for all circuits we'll design. All right, and so I'm saying remember this for this entire semester, and if you're going to do any analog design later, remember VGS minus VT for any transistor biased in strong inversion must be at least 0.1 volt. All right. If I find a VGS minus VT less than 0.1 volt any of your designs, then I will not accept the design or I'll reduce the mark significantly. All right. Given that, what it means is that the gain we can get from this circuit, the highest gain we can get from this circuit is 29. All right. For the largest possible voltage swing. All right. And if we want a minimal voltage swing, then it will be double this amount and it will be 58. Of course, this is ignoring RO, right? We have ignored RO. If we include RO, this number will go down further. All right. Okay. Now let us say that I want to design this circuit for this gain of 29, I have to design it because now I don't know what is the value of RD I need to use to get this gain. All right. So you pause and you think about what value of RD you will use and what value of the DC gate voltage you need to use to get this voltage gain. This is an important exercise because you're starting to do design. All right. So pause and calculate or find VG and RD. Okay, so let us solve. So first thing we say is, well, for we said that to get this 29, VGS minus VT must be 0.1. We already know VT is 0.4. So we say, okay, the first thing we recognize is that VGS must be 0.5 volts, 0.4 plus 0.1. So that is the first point of the design. VGS minus VT is 0.1. And then why is this here? This is not really relevant. Then we say, no, okay, it is relevant because we are saying we are designing it for, we are designing this for the maximum voltage swing. And so we find the maximum voltage swing, which is VDD plus VGS minus VT, 3 plus 0.1 by 2. So that's 1.55 volts. And then we say, well, so this is the DC drain voltage of our design for getting a gain of 29. Then we use this Ohm's law for RD. So we said 1.55 must be equal to 3 minus ID times RD. RD is what we need to find. ID we know actually because we know VGS minus VT. So ID is that mu and C ox W by L, which is 4 divided by 2. So 2 into VGS minus VT, which is 0.1 squared into RD. And so from this equation, we find RD to be 72.5 kilo ohms. So RD has become much larger, right? We had started with 2 kilo ohms, and in fact, we said by 10, the transistor goes into triode. But now this is 72 because the current has become smaller. Why has the current become smaller? Because VGS minus VT has become smaller. All right. So as I said, it is all connected. And the best way to find maximal gain is to go by this equation of VDD minus VO by VGS minus VT. So the current for this design is only 20 microamps. I should not say only, for MOSFETs it is not a bad current actually. For bipolars this is a very small current. Anyway, okay. VGS minus VT, by the way, is often called the overdrive voltage. That is the, because in the drain current equation, this is what is important, the quantity VGS minus VT. So it's called the overdrive voltage and it is denoted as VOV, and we will do this often from now onwards. All right. Now I'm doing a design. So with the same circuit, so till now we analyze, now let us do a design. So we are given the threshold voltage and the mu and C ox. And thus we are asked to design this circuit to meet these three specifications. All right. So that is, the design is, as opposed to analysis, is when we are given the specifications and we are asked to find the voltages, the resistances, and for MOSFETs, the W by L ratio. All right. So we are told that we must get a drain current of 0.5 milliamps. The voltage gain must be greater than 40, and the output voltage swing must be greater than 1.6 volts peak to peak. Right? Peak to peak means an amplitude of 0.8 volts. So we have to meet these specifications by finding or designing for values of the gate voltage, the drain resistance, and the W by L of the MOSFET. So let us go through this circuit. I am asking you to pause. I think there was a pause somewhere, and design the circuit. All right. Now, here is the pause. Okay. So, here is how we'll design. Generally speaking, so we already know that the lower the overdrive voltage, the higher is the gain. And the gain is given to be 40, which is it's a reasonable gain for this circuit, right? It is between 29 and 58. So we say, well, let us start with the lowest possible VOV, which is 0.1, so that we'll have freedom to vary other parameters. So VOV is 0.1 means VG is 0.5. Then we say, okay, we want ID to be 0.5 milliamps and VG is 0.5. So we put that in this equation and we find W by L from this. So the W by L turns out to be 500. All right, 0.5 milliamp equal to mu and C aux was 0.2 divided by 2 W by L into 0.1 squared. That gives us W by L of 500. Right, now W by L of 500,000 are common in analog circuits, amplifier circuits. All right, so don't get panic if you see 500 and 1,000. In digital circuits, W by L of 500 is very uncommon, extremely uncommon. In amplifier circuits, it is okay, no problem at all. All right, so okay, so we found VG, we found W by L. Let us find RD such that the gain and the swing specs are met. So let's look at the gain equation. So this is a gain equation. We are told that the gain must be 40. So this equation must be satisfied. And VGS minus VT is 0.1. So the only unknown is VO. So we solve this and we find that VO is 1 volt. VO is the DC drain voltage. Needs to be 1 volt. All right. Now let us find the RD to get this VO. So RD is 3 minus VO by ID. So that is 3 minus 1 by, I'm sorry, ID was how much? ID was 0.5 milliamps. It's a mistake. I'm sorry. So ID is 0.5 milliamps. So how much does that make? 2 by 0.5 is 4 kilo ohms. Okay. All right. So 4 kilo ohms, 0.5 volts, and W by L is 500. So this is again, this is 4 kilo ohms. Should meet the spec. I think I have, let me see if I have done this. Okay. Okay, so one thing about doing designs is that whenever you finish a design, so now we or I have finished this design. Okay, I found the W by L, I found VG, I found RD. Now, often what happens is we make a mistake in something somewhere, as I did in fact here. This was a mistake. And we end up with a set of numbers which may not be correct and which may not meet the specifications. All right, so it is an extremely good idea that once we finish a design, we check it. Now, how do we check it? So we draw this circuit with the completed design, and now we forget everything that we did up to this point, and we analyze this circuit. We say, okay, this is a circuit given to us. VG is given, W by L is given, RD is given. Let me analyze this circuit. Find the DC drain current, the DC drain voltage. Find the voltage gain, find the output voltage swing. All right. When we do that, and if the specifications are met, then we are satisfied that our numbers are correct. All right. So I'm not going to do this, but I would like you to analyze this circuit and make sure that it is meeting all the specifications that we started out with. All right. The other thing I'm telling you here is that it is possible that the given set of specifications may not be met by a circuit. So let's go back. So we were given this circuit and we are asked to meet these three specifications. So for example, if the output voltage swing specification was given to be 2 volts, you will find that you will not be able to meet the specifications with this circuit. All right, or for example, right off the bat, if the voltage gain was given to be 70, we already saw that the highest gain this circuit will give is 58. So if this gain was 70, you can just say, well, sorry, this circuit will not give us a gain of 70 at all. All right, so design always leaves the possibility of the specifications not being able to being met. All right, so that is this lecture. This is a shorter lecture because I wanted to complete this common source amplifier with RDE. Next lecture, we'll look at other common source configurations.